Tomorrow, our newest commander will lead part of a mission to strike a great blow to the Darkspawn. Not only does this recover access to some of our most important mines, but it also allows our honored guest Duncan, head of Ferelden's Grey Wardens, to strike far into the Deep Roads.
We need more Grey Wardens like you, and quickly. Even as the Darkspawn weaken here in Ozimor, they are stirring on the surface. A blight has begun.
Trian would make a terrible king, but no one wants to say it. He has just enough backing in the Assembly to make it ugly when your father dies, but not enough to become king.
I never thought his much-proclaimed honor would allow him to actually act on his jealousy. Big brother, Trian is going to try to kill you.
By the stone, it's Trian!
This doesn't look like Darkspawn. Bites, no scratches, no mutilation.
Hurry, father, before it's too...
By all the ancestors, what has happened here?
It seems we weren't fast enough. Valand was right.
It was terrible. Prince Trian didn't stand a chance.
You treacherous bastard!
Bind him. He will be judged before the Assembly.
You are to be sealed in the Deep Roads to fight Darkspawn until you are overwhelmed and killed. That may have been Balin's first mistake. Lord Harrowmont gave me access to see you so I could tell you this. Duncan and the Grey Wardens are still in the Deep Roads, in tunnels connected to those you are to be left in. If you survive long enough to find the Grey Wardens, you may be able to escape with Duncan. Our time is up. May the Paragons guide your sword and the stone hold you up. I will always be your man, my Lord Idukin.
Hello everybody and welcome back to Let's Play Dragon Age, and also welcome back to the echoey voice of Doom. Sorry, I'm still at my dad's, and unfortunately it boils down to really at this point, either I, you know, don't record any videos until I get back home, whereby I can actually have decent voice quality again, or I actually, and just basically leave you guys hanging with no videos for like the next week, or I record videos while I'm here in this big echoey room, and that way at least you guys have something to watch even if it sounds a bit strange. So anyway, yeah, back again with the echoey voice of Doom. Sorry about that, but without further ado, let's get on with it. I'm ready. I'm here. Harold's here. I've got a bottle of beer to wet my whistle as we go along as well. If you're interested, it's Old Golden Hen, that's what it's called, and it's damn good actually. I highly recommend it. Anyway, I'm gonna put that to one side now and let's do this. So previously, Harold here was tricked by his brother Balin, his dearest little brother Balin, and was framed for killing Trian, his older brother. And now he's been sentenced to exile, or he shall go out to the Deep Roads and fight the Darkspawn until he is overwhelmed and killed. However, thanks to Gorim, we know that the Grey Wardens are still out here, in tunnels connected to this one. And if we find them, they might just accept us into the Grey Wardens. Let us join them. Duncan did express some interest, after all, when we met him previously. And if we can join them... that's always ominous, isn't it? An auto-save like that. Anyway, if we can find them and join them, we might have a chance of escaping to the surface. A place where Harold has never been and has had no desire to go to either, I might add. So yeah, but we'll be back, Ozomar. We will be back. Don't you worry, to wreak our vengeance on every single one of you who was involved in this horrific indignity I am now suffering. We'll start with you, giant spider. Oh yeah. Show him who's the boss, Harold. Oh. You were doing so well, you hadn't had a single miss.
Ah!
Nice, good finishing moves. One of the perks to being a melee character in this game, actually, is you get some pretty sweet-looking finishing animations. Alright, so we've got some armor, a short bow, and a greatsword. Well, I'll take all, but I'm only really interested in the armor. Though we don't have any boots, so we're going to be barefooting it for a little while. As a result. So, more blue glowiness. Someone did actually say, so they suggested in one of the previous videos, that this stuff here might actually be lyrium veins. And I hadn't thought of that, but that would actually make perfect sense. So there we go. Hello. Oh, Christ, Darkspawn. Yeah, come over here, you. I'm not running down that long hallway to get to you, Mr. Archer. There we go, interrupted his special attack thing. Whatever that was he was doing. Quite so, Harold. Perfect example there of Dragon Age's thrilling combat. For those of you who have played the game before, you may be wondering actually what I intend to do about a certain section of the game that comes later on, known as the Fade. For those of you who have not played this game before, you will not have any idea what I'm talking about, and therefore shouldn't be too much of a spoiler. People may be wondering what I'm going to be doing about the Fade. I'm not going to be skipping it. I'm not going to be using the mod that allows you to skip it. But what I will do is I will heavily edit it down for you guys, so you don't have to suffer through most of it. I like to do the Fade simply because, well, you know what, we'll discuss it more at the time. Now is not the time. Now is the time to be killing Genlocks. Less talking, more raiding! As the old Sea Raiders from Mountain Blade would put it. Some gloves. Who's this here? Possibly a previous exilee? Didn't fare too well, did he? There we go. Right then. Multiple choice of pathways? No, actually no. Just, I was getting a bit confused. And oh god, more bear traps. That looks like it would be painful. Especially in bare feet. Right. It's tremendously well lit down here, isn't it? I have to admit, considering we are hundreds of miles below ground, in theory. Oh my goodness. See what I mean? Bane of my existence. These things just... Just have to sit through this little animation every time you get stuck in one. Okay, now I am getting a little bit... confuzzled. Right, I think this is the way we're meant to go. I do want to check out that side passage, though. Smack.
Let's make this quick, shall we?
Come on, Aaron. What the heck happened there? Did he just die of bleeding damage or something? I don't know. Anyway. This looks... Aha, yes, there's loot down there. I can see it. So, these videos actually, so far, they've proven a lot more popular than I thought they would, to be fair. Actually. I was quite surprised, actually, the reception this series has gotten so far. Glad to hear it, though. Glad you guys are enjoying it. I'm enjoying it. It's been quite some time since I did a decent... serious playthrough of this game, and it's good to be able to share it this time around. So just doing it by myself. I knew it. Eat that. Failed to capitalize on that because you missed again. Well done, Harold. Oh dear. Just kill him, come on. There you go. Large Darkspawn shield. It might be better than what we've got at the minute. It is better. Well, you know, beggars can't be choosers. come on, really? Doesn't look like he's wearing a strange backpack now, I don't have to admit, but never mind. So, where does this lead? I thought we were... Is it dead end? I want to go back and check the other route. The obsessive compulsive looter in me can't bear the thought of leaving a piece of loot behind down an unexplored passageway, so I'm gonna have to go look, guys, I'm sorry. As I thought. Small darkspawn shield. We've got a large darkspawn shield now, so I imagine we probably don't need this, do we? No.
Let's get started.
We can't get in that. Well, never mind. It was worth checking. Never know, it could have been I don't know, just, you know, like a pair of boots would have been nice. Gotta say. Never mind. Where did you come from? You weren't there last time. Oh, it's a Genlock rogue. That's probably why I didn't see him. Smack.
Excellent.
Sooner we get out of here and find the Grey Wardens, the better. I have to say, the combat in this game, when you're not in a party and you're just by yourself, hence me mentioning the Fade earlier. I see you, Bear Trap. Not today. The single combat in this game, when you're in scenarios like this, is just dreadfully dull. It really is. It's like MMO combat. It really is, with the hotbar and everything. This game's combat really shines once you actually get a full party and you can actually do some tactical stuff. Right now, though, I feel like I'm clearing a starter dungeon in World of Warcraft, frankly, but never mind. Superior Dwarven Guard armor, hello. Wow, that's quite good. I love that, thanks very much. Still don't have any boots, though. Oh, my kingdom for some shoes. Okay, two ways to go from here, left or right. Go right. No, let's go left. That leads back out onto the deep roads, so I'm assuming that's the way we actually are supposed to be going. Whereas this way, looks like it... Wait a minute. This way, I think. Yeah, this way might have some shoes. I don't want to turn up to Ostagar in my bare feet. I'm not a hobbit, for Christ's sake. Ah. Right. Deep Stalker leader. Let's get rid of you first, then. You're talking to mindless subterranean animals, Harold. I'm pretty sure fear isn't their weakness here. Well, okay, fine, but that's not what I meant to do. So, anyone bring a pack of cards, maybe? Game of Monopoly, maybe? At least we're down the last one, finally. Oh, yeah, God, this game's combat. Mixed bag, really. Sometimes it's fantastic, sometimes it's like this. What can I say, really? Oh, goodness me. Finally. Right, whatever, there better be some bloody... Yes, there's some boots, finally. Ugh. Oh. And some dwarven armor. That's not as good as what I'm wearing now. It does look kind of cool, though. It's like kind of like what Gorin was wearing, isn't it? I think. Well, not quite, but never mind. This is better, though. Hooray, shoes. Not something you'd expect to be saying, I think, Harold, when you woke up this morning. Oh, they're exactly the same. Fine, whatever. Alright then, okay, let's do this. Armed with our darkspawn shield. Naked dwarf? Yeah, this way. We are a sorry sight, aren't we? Harold is still probably fuming at this point, the steam coming out of his ears. We'll get our revenge one day! One day, not exactly sure how. But one day. Aha!
By the Maker, it's a dwarf!
Lord Idukan, what are you doing here alone? Where are your troops?
That's a long story. One question at a time, yeah. Grey Wardens aren't the only ones who can survive here. Harumph.
I'm aware of your family's experience with these tunnels, but no dwarf has set foot here for years. May I ask what happened?
I have been exiled.
Exiled? To these tunnels of death? What crime could be so terrible?
I do not think matters of dwarven honor or any business of ours. You need not answer, friend.
Well, I was betrayed by my brother, I don't mind saying.
Lord Treon?
No, Balin. Treon is dead.
I see. The brutal intrigue of the Dwarven Court continues then. Your father intimated as much. There is no reason for you to walk these deep roads and die for something you did not do. You've already proven yourself both resourceful and skilled, and I would expect nothing less from an Idukan. I've been searching for those with your level of ability. Your exploits in the Deep Road set you apart. As leader of the Grey Wardens in Ferelden, I would like to formally invite you to join our order.
Well, I can't see as I have much choice.
Then welcome. We leave immediately for Ostagar to join with the human forces facing the Darkspawn hordes led by King Kaelin. Stay close. There are still Darkspawn around every corner.
And there we go, folks. What, you didn't seriously think that we weren't going to find them and then just die at the end? Well, would have been a short let's play, wouldn't it?
We will be travelling south through the hinterlands to the ruin of Ostagar, on the edges of the Korkari Wilds. The Tevinter Imperium built Ostagar long ago to prevent the Wilders from invading the northern lowlands. It's fitting we make our stand here, even if we face a different foe within that forest. The King's forces have clashed with the Darkspawn several times, but here is where the bulk of the Horde will show itself. There are only a few Grey Wardens within Ferelden at the moment, but all of us are here. This blight must be stopped, here and now. If it spreads to the north, Ferelden will fall.
Ho there, Duncan.
King Kaelin. I didn't expect a
royal welcome? I was beginning to worry you'd miss all the fun.
Not if I could help it, Your Majesty.
Then I'll have the mighty Duncan at my side in battle after all. Glorious. The other wardens told me you'd found a promising recruit. I take it this is he?
Allow me to introduce you, Your Majesty.
There's no need to be so formal, Duncan. We'll be shedding blood together after all. Ho there, friend. Might I know your name?
I am no friend of yours, human lord. That's probably what Harold is thinking. However, we are royalty ourselves, and we've been brought up to respect, you know, royalty in general and just sort of stuff like that. So I think we'll be as polite as is necessary. I am Harold, Your Majesty.
Pleased to meet you. The Grey Wardens are desperate to bolster their numbers, and I, for one, am glad to help them. It's good to see one of the honorable stout folk outside Ordemar.
Stout folk? How much do you know about dwarves, Your Majesty?
I've always wanted to learn more. Perhaps you could enlighten me sometime.
Don't you have a battle to fight first?
I meant after we defeat the Blight, of course. I doubt Loghain will give me a moment's rest until then. I've been to Orzammar. King Endrin invited my father to a grand proving long ago. How does Endrin fare these days?
Sort of sitting here quite indignantly at this point, the fact that we've not been recognised, you know, Prince I Duke and all that. It's just sort of like, this guy has no idea. We're starting to get a little bit like, oh, they just... I am his son, and he was fine when I saw him last.
Well, it seems your story may be even more interesting than I suspected. Allow me to be the first to welcome you to Ostagar. The Wardens will benefit greatly with you in their ranks.
Polite or indifferent? I think Harold is too annoyed to be too polite. We'll see about that.
I'm sorry to cut this short, but I should return to my tent. Loghain waits eagerly to bore me with his strategies.
Your uncle sends his greetings and reminds you that Redcliffe forces could be here in less than a week.
Ha! Eamon just wants in on the glory. We've won 3 battles against these monsters, and tomorrow should be no different.
I didn't realize things were going so well.
I'm not even sure this is a true blight. There are plenty of darkspawn on the field, but alas, we've seen no sign of an archdemon.
Disappointed, Your Majesty?
I'd hoped for a war like in the tales. A king riding with the fabled Grey Wardens against a tainted god. But I suppose this will have to do. I must go before Loghain sends out a search party. Farewell, Grey Wardens.
What the king said is true. They've won several battles against the Darkspawn here.
He didn't seem to take the Darkspawn very seriously.
True. Despite the victories so far, the Darkspawn horde grows larger with each passing day. By now, they look to outnumber us. I know there is an archdemon behind this, but I cannot ask the king to act solely on my feeling.
Why not? He seems to regard the Grey Wardens highly.
Yet not enough to wait for reinforcements from the Grey Wardens of Orlais. He believes our legend alone makes him invulnerable. Our numbers in Ferelden are too few. We must do what we can, and look to Terran Loghain to make up the difference. To that end, we should proceed with the joining ritual without delay.
Sorry, Terran Hugain? Well, anyway, never mind. Well, down to business. What do you need me to do?
Feel free to explore the camp here as you wish. All I ask is that you do not leave it for the time being. There is another Grey Warden in the camp by the name of Alistair. When you're ready, seek him out and tell him it's time to summon the other recruits. Until then, I have business I must attend to. You may find me at the Grey Warden tent on the other side of this bridge, should you need to.
And there we have it, ladies and gentlemen. Origin story complete. Did I manage to pick up any gloves? No, I'm sick of these leather ones. Well, not for much longer. Yes, here we are. In Ostagar. Again, my improv poetry seems to be remarkably good of late. Anyway, one thing I would like to say is that I feel like this transition from the end of the Origins story you've been doing to Ostagar, I don't know, I've always felt it was a bit brief. Really? Like, I think maybe there should have been a little bit more in between, rather than just a sort of, like, 5-second cutscene and then BAM, here we are. I mean, come on, like, considering, like, say we've been doing the Dwarf Noble Origin, for example, we missed, like, for example... we missed Harold looking at the sky and the sun for the first time in his life. That would have been an interesting thing to see, you know, for example. And I've said for example about seven times now in the last minute or so, I suddenly realised. But anyway, never mind. Here we are. Complaint aside, minor though they may be. We've arrived in Ostagar. I think Harold's pretty impressed. I mean, look at this place. It's huge. I have to wonder how exactly whether or not he's gotten used to the whole open sky thing yet. But he doesn't really have a choice, does he? So we might as well just head on over here then and go see what we've got to do. We didn't know anything about a ritual, but apparently there is going to be a ritual, but never mind. Can't be anything too serious. Probably just saying a few silly words and then, you know, we'll get inducted and whatnot.
You must be the Grey Warden recruit that Duncan brought.
Yes, indeed. So yeah, Grey Warden, or soon to be Grey Warden Harold, as opposed to Prince Harold Iduken. That's going to take some getting used to as well, I think, and well, on the one hand, Harold definitely wants to seek his revenge upon his brother, but on the other hand, well, you know, he's not stupid. The Darkspawn are a serious threat, and a little bit more pressing to deal with than his murderous brother. So, for now, he's gonna, you know, exercise a bit of self-discipline, forget about Orzammar and Balin and all that sort of nonsense for now, and just focus on Grey Wardening. You know, he's had plenty of experience fighting the Darkspawn before, and he expects that most of the other Grey Warden recruits, once we meet them anyway, will not have much experience with the Darkspawn, so he feels pretty self-confident and everything. So anyway, we're going to swagger on into Ostagar here, and my PC's going to crash. That's what's going to happen. Luckily, on that problem, which I explained in the last video, I have discovered that DXStory does come with a extra utility known as Avi Fix, I think it's called, which basically allows you to fix corrupted files that occur as a result of your computer dying on you or something like mine just did. Which means that all that footage I just recorded was not in fact lost. I got it back. I just had to use the utility to sort of fix the corrupted file. Ultimately though, I still would rather get a new power supply unit and actually fix the computer rather than dealing with, you know, deal with the problem at its source rather than just put up with the symptoms. This is the best I can do at the minute, considering I don't have an extra 100 quid lying around just to spend on random computer parts. So anyway, never mind. What I was actually going to do was talk to this gentleman here, so let's do that. And then I'll level up, because I know some of you are screaming at me to level up.
This place hasn't seen such bustle in centuries, I'll wager. Need a hand getting anywhere?
I'm looking for a Grey Warden named Alistair.
Try heading north. I think he was sent with a message to the Majors.
Right. Okay, I'll be on my way then.
Good luck to you then.
Majors? Harold's never seen a mage. This should be interesting. Now then. Right. Ah, yeah, it contributes to accuracy of melee attacks. Alright, yeah, someone gave me a pointer in the last video that strength is actually what increases melee attacks, I think, for these characters like Harold. Rather than dexterity. So putting points into dexterity wasn't particularly useful, other than I think I do need it for some of my shield specialties, but, you know, that was worth knowing. I didn't realise that. I think I've been playing too much Dungeons & Dragons, because in Dungeons & Dragons, dexterity is what increases your hit chance. Anyway, never mind. What should we put this into? Let's put a point into Constitution and put the rest into Cunning. Might seem a little unusual, but it's because of this. There we go. Improved coercion. I want Harold to be quite coercive. mostly because I want him to be able to intimidate the crap out of people. Not because he's going to be particularly persuasive. But also, I think having a decent cunning level kind of suits his character anyway. And yeah, sure, he's gained a bit of cunning now as a result of learning from his previous mistakes. RE getting completely outwitted by his brother. So anyway, we also have a talent, a talent point to spend. It's probably going to be one of these, isn't it? Let's see, shield. Maybe all of them, or maybe... Precise strike. Alright, okay, I need precise striking in order to get taunt. Taunt would be jolly useful. Then so would one of these. I'm going to give a shield block before I get taunt, I think. I think that might be a better way to go. Because if I taunt, basically, what it does is, you know, mocking bellow catches the attention of nearby foes, increasing their hostility towards the warrior, blah, blah, blah. Basically, it aggroes enemies so that they attack Harold instead of our squishier party members. But before we go setting up Harold to go and taunt the crap out of people and, you know, act as a human shield, well, you know, a dwarf shield, never mind, I'd like to be able to prevent him from getting taking flanking damage. Before that happens, because when he does start taunting people, he will effectively be surrounded by hordes of angry enemies. So I think that's the most sensible route to go. I don't honestly know for sure. I haven't played a character quite like this before, and you know, an exceptionally tanky character like this before. I've always been a sort of DPS sort of a player, really. But you know, we're learning as we go. What on earth is this?
But the mages must not be interrupted.
Excuse me?
I'm sorry, but the mages must not be interrupted. The mages must not be interrupted. Their spirits are in the Fade.
In the what? Who? Fade?
The Fade is the realm of dreams and the land of the dead, or so the mages tell us. Regardless, they are not to be disturbed, not even by Grey Wardens.
Well, at least you recognize me. Fine, as you wish. Whatever. It's just curious. Of course, I need scarcely remind most of you, but Harold being a dwarf is completely devoid of any magical talent, because dwarves are immune to sort of, not really immune to magic, but you know what I mean, like no dwarf can become a mage. They're not connected to the Fade or something, I believe, and so he's completely oblivious to what the heck the Fade is. He won't know anything about demons, he won't know anything about magic or mages, and he won't have any preconceptions about them either, like some other characters might if they're coming from, say, the human background. So that's something that will obviously affect the way he interacts with a lot of people in this. Hence, he was quite curious to see what all that was about over there, but, you know, he got shooed off, so never mind. Hello.
Greetings, young man. You are Duncan's newest recruit, are you not? He's not a man easily impressed. You should be proud. Allow me to introduce myself. I am Wynn, one of the mages summoned by the king.
I've seen quite a few mages today.
The circle sent many. Mages have always helped in past blights. To defeat the darkspawn, we have to work together. It's not an idea everyone seems able to grasp.
You've faced darkspawn before?
Stragglers, yes. Not the vast horde the scouts speak of. I wonder, how much do you know of the connection between Darkspawn and the Fade?
Not much, being a dwarf.
It's home to many spirits, some benevolent, others far less so. At the heart of the Fade lies the Black City.
The Black City?
Some say the Black City was once the seat of the Maker. But when the mages from the Tevinter Imperium found a way into the city, it was tainted with their sin. That taint transformed those men, turning them into twisted reflections of their own hearts. And the Maker cast them back to the Earth, where they became the first Darkspawn. At least, that's what the Chant of Light says.
Sounds like a load of old tosh to me. Yep, you humans and your chantry.
It may be allegory, meant to teach us that our own evil causes human suffering. Or it may be true. It is as good an explanation as any for now.
I'll just kill every darkspawn I see.
a wise attitude. It's worked well for me in the past. But I'm certain Duncan has more for you to do than talk to me.
Indeed. Yeah, in case you hadn't already figured it out, Harold does not think much of the Chantry or its ideas. As far as Harold's concerned, I don't actually know, actually, because my knowledge of Dragon Age lore is a bit rubbish, honestly. But, as far as I'm aware, like, Harold probably doesn't believe any of that rubbish. As far as he's concerned, maybe the Darkspawn... I don't know, maybe they were a result of the dwarves, well, you know, cliche I know, delving too greedily and too deep, since that's when the Darkspawn kind of first appeared, down in the deep roads, underground. Perhaps if he had to speculate, he would say that the dwarves are actually responsible for unleashing the Darkspawn, maybe. He doesn't know exactly how, but that's where they first turned up, so that would make the most sense to him. As for this Chantry sort of, you know, mages corrupting the Maker's city nonsense, that he doesn't believe a word of that. Thinks it's complete rubbish. You know,
that pretty face could be decorating some Darkspawn spear this time tomorrow. Shall I take that quiet glare as a no? Oh, well, too bad.
Who are you?
Well, you're not what I thought you'd be.
And what did you think I'd be?
Not a dwarf, yet here you are. The name's Davith. It's about bloody time you came along. I was beginning to think they cooked this ritual up just for our benefit.
What do you know about this ritual?
I happened to be sneaking around camp last night, see, and I heard a couple of Grey Wardens talking. So, I listen in for a bit. I'm thinking they plan to send us into the wilds.
Maybe they will. We'll see.
It's all too secretive for me. Makes my nose twitch. I guess we'll have to wait and see. Like we have a choice.
Well, I wouldn't be here if I did. Yep, true enough.
You take what you get, right? Anyway, I expect it's time to get back to Duncan. That's where I'll be if you need me for anything.
What do we have here? A forge master of some description. Well, I need a new pair of gloves anyway.
Have you seen an elf running about? Young woman, red hair, carrying a suit of chain.
What if I have?
Oh, well, I'd like to know where she went, that's what. Oh, pardon my manners. My troubles are no concern of yours, I'm sure. I'm the quartermaster. Did you come for supplies?
What kind of supplies do you have?
Arms and armor, for the most part. It's for the King's men, but you Grey Wardens can buy what you need for a modest price. I also have some goods on the side I can provide. Strictly off the record, of course. To keep morale up, you understand.
What? Let me see these other goods.
So long as you keep it quiet.
Curious. What have we got? Anything useful? Every chain, Melee. Oh, that's expensive. Well, should probably sell some of this crap anyway. Tattered prison clothes. Well, yeah. Don't need Illyrian potions, being a dwarf and all. Injury kit, yep, keep that. Health poultices will stay. Right. How does that compare to what I'm wearing at the minute? That's not as good. Cool. I wouldn't mind a helmet. But mainly I want some gloves. There we go, yep. And a helmet, why not? Oh god, I can't afford it, never mind. I shall have that, thank you very much. I wouldn't mind replacing the Darkspawn shield, honestly, but, you know... at least we've got a shield, you know? I'll worry about it later. For now, though, I wanted some nice big heavy gauntlets as opposed to those rubbish leather gloves. And we've got those now, so let's go and find this Alistair Duncan spoke of.
What is it now? Haven't Grey Wardens asked more than enough of the Circle?
I simply came to deliver a message from the revered mother, Sir Mage. She desires your presence.
What her reverence desires is of no concern to me. I am busy helping the Grey Wardens, by the King's orders, I might add.
Should I have asked her to write a note?
Tell her I will not be harassed in this manner.
Yes, I was harassing you by delivering a message.
Your glibness does you no credit.
Here I thought we were getting along so well. I was even going to name one of my children after you. The grumpy one.
Enough. I will speak to the woman if I must. Get out of my way, fool.
Who's he calling fool?
You know, one good thing about the Blight is how it brings people together.
Yeah, we do know exactly what he means, actually, in a way.
It's like a party. We could all stand in a circle and hold hands. That would give the Darkspawn something to think about. Wait, we haven't met, have we? I don't suppose you happen to be another mage.
How can a dwarf be a mage?
You never know. These mages sneak up on you. Wait, I do know who you are. You're Duncan's new recruit from Orzammar. I should have recognized you right away. I apologize.
How could you recognize me? Because you're a dwarf, Harold. How else? And you must be Alistair.
Did Duncan mention me? Nothing bad, I hope. As the junior member of the Order, I'll be accompanying you when you prepare for the joining.
I can't prepare on my own.
I know. I felt the same way when I did this. Unfortunately, they don't give us much choice. There haven't been any Dwarven Grey Wardens in some time. You must know a lot about Darkspawn.
I've fought a few in my time.
I never saw one before this began. Hard to believe most folks here think the Darkspawn disappeared after the last Blight, when your people still suffer every day. Anyhow, whenever you're ready, let's get back to Duncan. I imagine he's eager to get things started.
Let's go.
If you have any questions, let me know. Otherwise, lead on.
Well, Alice has certainly gone up slightly in Harold's estimates. A little bit. I think it was mainly that comment about how he recognizes that the dwarves suffer every day. Could you maybe? Thank you. Right. That little comment there, I think maybe made Harold think, fair enough then. Okay. He's not quite as ignorant as he would expect from your average human. So that's cool. Gonna have a poke around up here. Here we go.
In the name of Andraste, I bless you today. May you find favor in the Maker's eyes. So let it be.
Very strange shiny effect on whatever that is underneath the wood. Odd. Never mind. What do we have here? Who are you?
I heard that some Darkspawn use magic. How? They're animals.
Greetings. You must be the third recruit we've heard about.
I am. Who are you?
Sir Jury is my name. I hail from Redcliffe, where I served as knight under the command of Arlaemon. I wasn't aware dwarves could be Grey Wardens. I've only seen a few of your folk in the castle dealing with the smithy.
Of course they can be Grey Wardens. Why on earth couldn't they be?
Since the Grey Wardens protect human lands, I guess the dwarf would not wish to join. Obviously I'm wrong. I hope we're both lucky enough to eventually join the Wardens. Well. Is it not thrilling to be given that chance?
He's not wrong, is he? Yeah, I wouldn't be here if I had a choice in the matter.
I fought hard to get here. Impressing Duncan was not easy. Tell me, has anyone told you what this joining ritual entails?
David said we might be going into the wilds.
I never heard of such a ritual. I had no idea there were more tests after getting recruited. I suppose since you're finally here, I'd best get back to Duncan. I shall see you there.
Very well. And yes, in case you're wondering, I did already point this out, but I do have a mod installed which changes the way some of the NPCs in the game look. So Jory among them. He looks slightly less, I don't know, oafish. A little bit more like the knight he's supposed to be, I guess.
Welcome to the King's camp, my lord.
Like this fella, for example. Anyway.
Ah, I suspect you are one of the new Grey Wardens. Will you accept the Maker's blessing?
As you can see, mine are dwarven kin.
I do. Though I cannot pass on the respects of your ancestors, the Maker looks kindly on all who will receive him.
Keep your worthless mumblings to yourself, priest.
Typical heathen. Be gone, then. That the Grey Wardens accept the likes of you is forever their greatest weakness.
And that's why Harold doesn't like the Chantry. Anyway, moving on. What's this about here? What is this curious looking beast? I have never seen the likes of one of these before.
This isn't good. I'd hate to waste such a promising member of the breed. Are you the new warden? I could use some help.
Yeah, I don't know anything about dogs, is that what you call them?
It's not what you know so much as what you are, really. This is a Mabari, smart breed and strong. His owner died in the last battle, and the poor hound swallowed darkspawn blood. I have medicine that might help, but I need him muzzled first.
Just how smart is this dog?
Centuries ago, a mage bred them to be smart and understand what they're told. They can remember and carry out complex orders. Most valuable dogs in the world. Trouble is, they generally imprint to one master. Reimprinting them is very difficult. But without the medicine, reimprinting won't be an issue. Will you help?
Oh, that's disappointing. Oh. Okay, Harold's curious enough, I suppose. Could he be imprinted to me?
We can try, but first we need to muzzle and medicate him.
What do you think I could muzzle him?
You're a Grey Warden, or soon will be. All Wardens are immune to the Darkspawn taint. The most you have to worry about is some tooth marks.
Well, I'm not a warden yet, so maybe you could help me, Master?
Nope, dogs and I don't get along. You do it if you're so eager. Just leave me out of it.
Oh, fine. I'll give it a shot.
Go in the pen and let him smell you. We'll know right away if he'll respond. Let's hope this works. I'd really hate to have to put him down.
Christ, he's almost as tall as me. Okay, we'll try to put the muzzle on the dog. Kill the dog. I've never done that before. I don't know why you would. Oh, dear.
Well done. Now I can treat the dog properly, poor fella. Come to think of it, are you heading into the wilds anytime soon?
Might be, actually. Why?
There's a particular herb I could use to improve the dog's chances. It's a flower that grows in the swamps here, if I remember. If you happen across it, I could use it. It's very distinctive, all white, with a blood-red center.
Do you think I have nothing better to do? Let's see. I'll be alright without it. Yep, dumb question. Of course not. Why didn't you get it yourself? Well, because he's busy with all the other dogs. Where in the wilds would I find this flower, exactly?
It usually grows in dead wood that collects at the edge of ground pools. Should be plenty this time of year.
Alright, let's see if I can find one.
Good. In the meantime, I'll begin treating our poor friend.
Well, never mind then. Interesting. Harold's never seen a dog before. At least I don't think he would have seen a dog before. They don't have dogs in all in a while. He's interested, though. Sort of loyal beast of war would not be a terrifically bad thing to have around. Anyway. That's like kennels. Alright, anyway. Yes, that, by the way, spoiler, but that's a potential party member, the dog. Over there. Again, glad I'm not playing this blind, because on my first playthrough of this game, I completely missed the dog. Just entirely. Didn't even bother talking to the kennel master over there. I just went straight past him and never even realized that was a thing. So there you go. Had I done that in this playthrough, I am sure I would have been yelled at. So, Christ, I remember Variax getting told off for leaving the dog behind, and he did it for role-playing reasons. Anyway, hello.
You found Alistair, did you? Good. I'll assume you're ready to begin preparations. Assuming, of course, that you're quite finished riling up mages, Alistair.
What can I say? The revered mother ambushed me. The way she wields guilt, they should stick her in the army.
She forced you to sass the mage, did she? We cannot afford to antagonize anyone, Alistair. We don't need to give anyone more ammunition against us.
You're right, Duncan. I apologize.
Now then, since you're all here, we can begin. You four will be heading into the Kokari Wilds to perform two tasks. The first is to obtain 3 vials of darkspawn blood, 1 for each recruit.
What do we need darkspawn blood for?
For the joining itself. I'll explain more once you've returned.
Fair enough. But surely you could have acquired some blood before now.
Of course. You must work together to collect the components, however. It's as much a part of the joining as what comes after.
I see. Strange, but fine. What's the second task?
There was once a Grey Warden archive in the wilds, abandoned long ago when we could no longer afford to maintain such remote outposts. It has recently come to our attention that some scrolls have been left behind, magically sealed to protect them. Alistair, I want you to retrieve these scrolls if you can.
What kind of scrolls are these?
Old treaties, if you're curious. Promises of support made to the Grey Wardens long ago. They were once considered only formalities. With so many having forgotten their commitments to us, I suspect it may be a good idea to have something to remind them with.
And what if they're no longer there?
It's possible the scrolls may have been destroyed or even stolen, though the seal's magic should have protected them. Only a Grey Warden can break such a seal.
I don't understand. Why leave such things in a ruin if they're so valuable?
Good point.
It was assumed that we would someday return. A great many things were assumed that have not held true.
Very well. How will we find this archive, though?
It will be an overgrown ruin by now, but the sealed chest should remain intact. Alistair will guide you to the area you need to search.
Fine. So, find the archive and the 3 vials of blood. Got it.
Watch over your charges, Alistair. Return quickly and safely.
We will.
Then may the Maker watch over your path. I will see you when you return.
Huzzah! And we now have a party of followers. Once more. Which means hopefully the upcoming combat should be significantly less boring. However, there are one or two things over here, I think, that are worth having a look at. Hello.
You approach the tent of Taren Loghain. State your business.
Tell me about Taren Loghain. I have no idea who this guy is. Duncan mentioned him. I don't know anything else.
How can you not know of Loghain? He helped free Ferelden. He was the brains behind King Marek's armies and drove out those damned Orlesians. King Marek rewarded him by making him a Taren. Can you imagine? A commoner became a high nobleman just like that. Without Loghain, you can bet the king wouldn't be winning against these darkspawn.
Commoners have become kings in all the world before, I think. I probably wouldn't find that particularly impressive, although, you know, fairly impressive, but not astounding, I suppose. Is he inside? What's he doing?
He's inside, but I don't think it's my place to discuss his activity.
What, is he up to something pretty... well, Damn your eyes, I'd like an audience with the Terran.
I suppose you have a message for him. Hold on then.
Speak to him ourselves.
Yes, what is it? Oh, you're Duncan's new Grey Warden, I assume.
Yes, I am.
Kalan's fascination with the Wardens goes beyond the ordinary. Are you aware his father brought your order back to Ferelden?
Fascination you don't share.
The Wardens are impressive, but not as relevant as Kalan thinks. You're no surface dwarf, I can see it in your eyes. Smart are the Grey Wardens to look for new recruits in Orzammar. I don't suppose you'll be riding into the thick of battle with the rest of your fellows, will you?
Well, I certainly bloody hope so.
Here for the glory, huh? Fair enough. Now I must return to my task. Pray that our king proves amenable to wisdom, if you're the praying sort.
He's not my king. Don't seem very fond of him. He seems like a fool to me. Well, yep, I think he does, and I don't think Harold's too afraid to share his thoughts on the matter.
He is Marek's son and the leader of my beloved Ferelden, and a very young man. I try to keep that in mind, as should you.
Gah, my little brother Balin's got more brain cells to rub together than this Kalen. But whatever. That said, Kalen's not an evil scumbag. But then again, Harold's really not got a terrific amount against being an evil scumbag. He's just annoyed that he happened to be on the receiving end of said evil scumbag.
Greetings. King Kalen is not in his tent right now.
Tell me about him. You must see him a lot.
I suppose I do. Though he's spending most of his time with the Grey Wardens. He rides with them wherever they go, in fact. Terran Loghain sees the king whenever he can and argues with him over coming battles, but the king just waves him off. The king wants to end the Blight with a single huge battle the bards will sing of for centuries. Do you think that's possible?
I have my doubts.
That's how the Terran feels. He'll do what the king wants in the end, though. The king thought it was funny the Terran called him reckless, and they fought about the queen.
Oh, dear. The more Harold finds out about these two, the more he seems to like Terran Loghain, and the less he seems to like Kalen, I think, actually. Loghain seems like a sensible sort. Certainly by comparison, anyway. Do they fight often?
More than usual lately. Good thing the Terran's the only one who can speak to the king like that.
Well, I should go.
As you wish.
So, we learned a little bit more about the king. We were not pleased.
Look carefully, man. This wretched thing is a darkspawn. They're strong and cunning and smart, but don't listen to those old wives' tales. They can be killed. Stick them with your sword enough, and they go down. Their blood is black as sin and poisonous. Don't even touch it. You get tainted with that blood, and you may as well slit your throat. We've lost many dogs already. Had to muzzle them to keep them from biting. It's a long and painful way to die. Whoa, don't touch the carcass. We'll be burning it so it doesn't infect anything.
Alright, I know the drill. Calm down.
This is supposed to be the battle that sends these darkspawn back underground. You believe that?
I don't know what to believe. We've won every battle, but there's more of them each time.
Makes you wonder if them Grey Wardens are right.
I don't want to think about that.
Sounds like the perfect time to get drunk, if you ask me. The last scouting party made it back last night. Barely.
What do you mean?
Only two of them made it. And one was minus a leg. Said they encountered some darkspawn that was 10 feet tall, with horns as long as your arm. The injured one died last night. They said his blood was already turning black.
Maker's breath. Where are they all coming from?
Curious. Although I don't think there's anything actually up here now. Now I'm here, and now I remember that's actually worth talking to. It's all just random bits of scenery, I think. Oh, a bloody priest.
The wall before me is darkness, yet shall the Maker's light.
Oh, yes, yes, you keep telling yourself that, love.
The wall before me is darkness,
yet shall the Maker's light. Right, well. Jolly impressive scenery. It's probably time we got to work.
There are lots of darkspawn, different kinds.
So we need to go this way.
You there, elf. What's your name?
It's Pick, sir.
Go tell Turnlow Gain that the war party's ready to begin scouting. We'll send word if we find anything amiss.
Yes, sir. Right away, sir.
These gentlemen look a little different.
You're the dwarf who walks with the Grey Wardens. A respectable decision.
You know much about us dwarves?
Some, like all Ash warriors. Our training originates from the dwarves. Is there something you wanted? We have no time for idle chatter.
I'm curious. Yeah, you don't look like the other soldiers in the army.
We aren't. We're Ash warriors, as you should well know.
You trained with the Dwarven Berserker warriors, then, is that correct?
Our discipline was passed down to us from the time of Luthias the Dwarf son. He trained with the Berserkers of your kind, long ago.
I see, so you're the same as the Berserkers in Orzammar then, more or less.
Perhaps. I've never been, so I cannot say for certain. But I'm told our traditions are the same. We harness the rage inside us, nurture it, and draw it out so we cannot fall in battle until our last foe is slain. It is a dwarven discipline, but we've adapted it to let us fight alongside our hounds. That is our way. I trust my hound with my life, as he trusts me with his.
So is a dog that good in combat?
A trained Mabari hound is as dangerous as any sword. We do not speak of a city pet or those things that sit in an old woman's lap.
Right. Why have you painted them?
They use scent to distinguish us from our enemies. But the blood of battle can confuse them. So we paint ourselves with Cadis, which overpowers the blood, and also paint our hounds so they know we are the same.
What if the enemy is painted with Cadis as well? Obviously the Darkspawn wouldn't paint themselves with Cadis, but these guys don't fight Darkspawn all the time.
Why? Would you steal our Cadis and give it to the Darkspawn hordes?
I hope you're joking.
If you tried, we would kill you. And that is no joke.
You're a bit of a simpleton, aren't you? Right, I'll be off anyway.
My thanks. There is hunting to be done, and I'll not be kept from it.
Interesting. Gentlemen, I have decided I want a Mabari. I'm going to go off and look for this flower. I wouldn't, you know, find that Darkspawn blood in those scrolls and stuff as well, I guess.
Hail. I'm told you all have business in the wilds. The gate's open for you. Just be careful out there. Even a Grey Warden won't be safe in the forest tonight.